2017 signing day, wrestling signing day. I am very privileged and honored to be able to see Delonte Myers. He was a kid who wrestled for me for 3 years. It's been a pleasure for him to wrestle for me. It's been an honor. I've seen him grow as a young man, as a student. I was honored all season to be able to be with him his senior year. Some of those things that I can just remember about Delonte is I remember when he first came in as a sophomore. He had wrestled for me as a youth, but he took a couple years off. But he came in the room challenging my upperclassmen. He was not afraid of a challenge. He had a successful year that year, and as his junior year, he was a city champ. And his senior year, it was an honor to be a part of seeing him be a city champ again. He was a sectional champ, and he was a district qualifier. I had the privilege of going on college visits with him. It was honorable, man, just to see how other schools appreciated him. It's just been a great pleasure and honor for me to be a part of his life and to see him in this day be able to have a choice of where he would want to go to school. Not to belabor the time, I just want to pass the floor on to some of the people, to some other people who were very important in his life. Thank you.
Christian Angel, I'm the leadership intern here in the building, and I will say this has been a great year here at Mifflin High School, especially my alma mater. I graduated from here in 97, and I'll tell you about Mr. Myers here. He is always smiling. He is always goofing off, like playing around. Like, you can always count on Mr. Myers to make you laugh or fuss and get to class or be where you need to be. But when I seen him wrestle, first of all, I was like acting like a scary mom watching the boys wrestle, like, oh my gosh, be careful. But to watch him on that mat, like, this guy is awesome. And he's like this quiet storm, because when you see him in the halls, you know, he's happy, he's joking around, but when you see him on that mat, like, is explosive, and he pinned those kids down so fast. I was like, oh, he won. I had to ask people, like, I think that was good. Was that good? So it's such a privilege to sit up here with you today and see you going off to the next level. And when you were watching you in the Olympics, or when we're watching you and being professionally here, like, remember us here at Mifflin High School. And we here, the whole Mifflin community, is so proud of you and all of your accomplishments. Not only are you doing this, but you're like graduating, and that's pretty awesome of you. So I'm really proud of you. Oh, Ms. Harris.
Yes. Hi, I'm Mrs. Harris. I am one of the safety and security officers here at Mifflin High School. Ms. Angel pretty much said everything that I wanted to say. But what I will say is I'm going to miss this young man walking these halls. As she said, he's funny, he's goofy, he likes to pick on me every day because I'm shorter than him. So he walks up and takes my pens and my tablets and my cell phone, and he likes to hold them above my head so that I can jump to try to get them. Like Miss Angel said, I had never really watched wrestling in the flesh, being there and seeing this young man out there on the mat, it amazed me. Because you would have never thought that he had that much power when you see him walking the halls, because as she said, he's very quiet. You really wouldn't even know who he was until you, seen him or talked to him. I had no clue who he was. He walked around this building for probably 4 months before I knew who he was. And then once I started talking to him, you just automatically like him instantly. So he's been a wonderful young man in the building, even though he takes my items from me daily. And I'm just excited for him, for the next level that he's going to, and I really wish him the best. And if I get an opportunity, I'm going to definitely go see him when he's in college. So I wish you the best, you and your family. Congratulations to both. You're welcome. And now it's time for Mr. Nick.
All right. My name's Nicholas C. I'm Delonte's dad. I came into his life when he was 4 years old, and been there ever since. And even though he's my stepson, there's nothing short of blood in there. I mean, we're very close, and he's always been very close to me. And over these last 12, 13 years that he's been in my life, it's each and every year he just amazes me more and more with his drive and the way he accomplishes everything that he does. There's nothing that he's not good at once he does it. I mean, he might, even stuff he reluctantly does, he's still very good at it, so that, which is pretty impressive. I mean, over the last 4 years with his high school, he definitely had a slower start than what me and his mom demanded out of him. So, you know, we're very strict with him, but I think he got frustrated at times how strict we was. But he exceeded our expectations, and I can't say nothing but how proud I am of him and how much I love him. And I'm speaking for me and his mother, and I'm very proud, and I'm anxious and excited to watch him wrestle on the next level and just become a man and succeed in life, because I know that not just on the wrestling mat, that in the world of, you know, having a career and being a man and eventually being a husband and a father, I know he'll be amazing at that, just like he is everything else he does. So I just want to tell you that I'm proud of you and congratulations.
I'm not really good at this talking in front of people, so I'm going to try. I wrote it on my phone. No. All right, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
All right, my whole high school career has been a roller coaster. From my grades going up and down to even my attitude. But from my freshman year to my senior year, I feel like I became a better person on and off the mat. I achieved a lot of accomplishments throughout my high school wrestling career, and I want to take it to the next level. I want to become an All-American. I want to be the guy that no one will ever forget. I'm going to become the best. But lastly, I couldn't even be here if it wasn't for my coaches, Coach C and Coach Ezra. My father, my mother, and my teammates, and everyone else, if I didn't name, you know, it's a lot of people, but I just, you know. Without them, none of this would be possible, and I really appreciate it. All of you with all of my heart. But as I said, I'm keeping it short, sweet, and simple. But with all that being said, I will be attending Adrian College in Michigan.